Hello everyone, welcome to new video from Talent Battle, your one-stop placement preparation platform. I'm Ajinkya, co-founder of Talent Battle. In this video, we are going to solve some previous year questions from TCS NQT which were asked on 3rd and 4th August 2019. We will be also uploading a lot of new videos for your TCS preparation. So make sure you subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to get all the updates. Now before starting with the questions, initially, I want to share some important information with you guys. Currently, TCS has not announced the dates yet about NQT exam, National Qualifier Test exam. But it is always better to start with the preparation. We have also launched our TCS specific preparation packages. All the content which is provided by us is top quality. Hundreds of students who prepared with us last year are successfully placed in TCS. I will give you an overview of what exactly we are going to provide. We have created two different packages based on the requirement from the students. One is silver package and another is gold package. I will give you the details of gold package for now and tell the difference between both the packages. But before that, one important experience I would like to share with you all. Maybe you have also experienced that. You might see some online preparation companies giving you fake placement count for TCS for the last year. Don't fall into that trap. That is nothing but a marketing trick. Showing a fake count of a huge number of students purchasing their courses so that you feel that you are the only one who is remaining to purchase that course. Guys, all that glitters is not gold. You need to understand that. Don't fall for a fancy website with the fake claims and waste your money. Now, let me give you the details of the package which we are going to provide and then we will start with the question. I have also added a feedback link of the students who attended our training, TCS training previously. So let me share the details of the gold package one by one. Now, as you can check on the screen, in TCS gold package, you are going to get TCS specific recorded training of 30 hours. Also, there will be live training sessions which will be conducted whenever TCS NQT will be announced. Second thing, TCS specific concept clearing aptitude lectures will be provided of 60 hours. Now you need to understand the difficulty level of TCS is usually higher as compared to other companies. So the basic concepts are very important. So that is the reason we are providing 60 plus hours of course. Once you go through that course, you don't need to refer any other website or any other book for your aptitude preparation. Next, we are going to provide you 12 TCS specific mock tests. All the mock tests are with the video solutions. So once you attend the test, if you are having any doubt, directly you can check the video solution. You don't need to wait for anyone to explain. Now, the gold package also includes online mock interview from industry expert. Next, to make sure students are ready with the technical part as well, we have provided C programming course, Java programming course, and as well as data structure course. You can check the contents or you can check basically the number of hours per course which we are going to provide. So in case if you are not good with any of the subjects, you can just revise that. Apart from that, 100 plus coding statements will be provided to you with the video solutions that will help you for your coding preparation. Next, resume preparation and personal interview training is also provided. We have also created technical interview course in which we have covered the questions which are usually asked for a technical interview for TCS. So that will also help you. And the next important part is full length and the topic wise aptitude test series. So you will be getting 50 plus tests topic wise, which will help you to do time management and also to understand your performance. For each and every test, you will get a detailed performance report where you can compare with the students across India, which will always help you to understand your rank whenever you are preparing for TCS. Now, these are some of the features of our platform. The expert trainers for aptitude and technical will be covering all the content. Video solutions, as I already mentioned, for the test pack. Structured preparation plan is provided. So it is not like that you register for the course and you need to do everything on your own. We provide you a recommended schedule also, which you can follow and prepare for TCS. The validity of the package is 2 years. There are some live doubt clearing sessions which we are going to plan for the TCS gold and silver package and the previous year questions which we are going to provide. Now, what is the difference between TCS Gold and Silver? The only difference is online mock interview is not available in TCS Silver package. All the other features I mentioned will be a part of Silver package. Don't worry about it. Now, I have added the link in the description box. In case of any doubt, you can message us on our platform. We'll be happy to clear your doubts. Now let's start with the previous.
In a country, 60% of the male citizen and 70% of the female citizen are eligible to vote. So let us consider there are total 100 male citizens and 200 female citizens. So total population of the village becomes 300. They are saying 60% of the male citizens are eligible to vote. So 60% of 100 will be 60. So there are 60 males who are eligible to vote. And they also said that there are 70% of the female citizens are eligible to vote. So 70% of 200 will be 140. Now they are saying 70% of the male citizens eligible to vote are voted. Okay. So there are total 60 male citizens who are eligible. And out of those eligible males, 70% of those eligible people voted. So 70% of 60 voted, so which is equal to 42. So 42 male citizens voted in the election. Next, they said 60% of the female citizens eligible to vote voted. So they are saying 60% of the eligible female students or citizens voted. So 60% of 140. Okay, so it will be equal to 84. So total 42 male citizens voted and total 84 female citizens voted. So total citizens voted are 42 plus 84, which is 126. Now they have asked what fraction of the citizens voted during the election. So they are asking what percentage of the total population voted. So 126 voted, total population was 300 multiplied by 100. So this turns out to be 42%, which is equal to 0.42. So the correct answer for this question is 0.42. Let's check the second question. A clock is started at noon. By 10 minutes past 5, the hour hand has turned through how many degrees? Okay. So basically, they are saying the clock started at 12 noon. And now the time is 10 minutes past 5, means it is 5:10. Then they are asking us the hour hand has turned through how many degrees. So basically they want to know the degrees which have been covered by hour hand in so much of time. Okay, so what is the time elapsed total from 12 noon to 5:10? Total 5 hours and 10 minutes. Okay, so 5 hours 10 minutes means total how many minutes have elapsed? 1 hour means 60 minutes, so 5 hour is 300 minutes plus this 10 minutes. So total 310 minutes have elapsed. Okay. Now, those who directly know that hour hand travels half degree in 1 minute, you can directly check if hour hand travels half degree in 1 minute, in 310 minutes, it will travel how many degrees? 310 multiplied by half, which is equal to 155 degrees. So the correct answer for this question is 155 degrees. But from where did we get our hand travels half degree in 1 minute? Let us check it in short. We know that our hand takes 12 hours to cover 360 degrees. Okay, how do we know this? Suppose the hour, it is 12 noon, the hour hand is on the 12 o'clock, okay? To cover the full 360 degree and again come on 12, it will take total 12 hours. So if our hand is on 12 at 12 noon, again it will be on 12 at 12 a.m. in the night. Okay. So in 12 hours, it covers 360 degrees. So in 1 hour, it will cover 30 degrees. Or I can say 1 hour means 60 minutes. In 60 minutes, it covers 30 degree. So in 1 minute, it will cover half degree. Okay. So if you know this directly, then you can easily solve this. In 1 minute it goes half degree, then in 310 minutes it will go 155 degrees. I will also give you one information about minute hand. Minute hand travels, in 1 minute it travels 6 degrees. So if you get a question based on minute hand, then also you should be able to solve this. Okay, let's check the next question. Ram speaks truth 40% of the time and Lakshman speaks truth 60% of the time. The percentage of cases Ram and Lakshman are likely to contradict each other in stating the same fact is. So this is a question based on probability basically. So just check Ram and Lakshman, truth, and I can say lie. So Ram speaks truth 40% of the times. 40% is nothing but 2/5. And if he speaks truth 40% of the time, that means he lies 60% of the time. So 60% is nothing but 3/5. And they said Lakshman speaks truth 60% of the times, which means 3/5. And that means he lies 40% of the time, which is 2/5. Now, the main thing here you need to locate is the percentage of cases Ram and Lakshman are likely to contradict. Contradict means opposite of each other. So what can be the cases of contradiction? Ram speaks truth and Lakshman lies, or Ram is lying and Lakshman is speaking truth. So these are the two cases. We need to find the probability or chances that they will contradict each other. Now, what is the chance that Ram speaks truth? It is 2/5. And means multiplication. And Lakshman lies. What is the chance that Lakshman lies? Lakshman lying chance is 2/5. Or means addition. Ram lies. Chance that Ram lies is 3/5. And chance that Lakshman speaks the truth is also 3/5. So now just check. This will become 4/25 plus 9/25, which is 13/25. So 13/25, if I want to convert into percentage, I can just multiply by 100. So this will be equal to 52%. So the correct answer for this question is 52%. Check this question now. Uma has 50 red and 50 blue balls. She has two bowls with her. Okay. She has to distribute the balls in these two bowls in such a way that none of the balls remains empty. If one were to choose one ball and two balls at random, then randomly draw one ball from it, the probability of the ball being red is maximized. After this distribution, there will be a total of dash balls in the ball with larger number of balls. Okay. Previously in our videos, we have checked such kind of problems where you need to maximize the probability of getting a single color ball. What they are saying, first they will distribute the balls in these two bowls. After distribution, they will pick one bowl and then they will pick one ball from that bowl, and they want to maximize the probability of being the red ball. So in such cases, what you need to do, you need to just keep one ball, one red ball in this bowl, and remaining 49 red balls and 50 blue balls in this bowl. So you can check, there will be a total of 99 balls in the bowl with larger number of balls, and there will be just one ball in this bowl. Okay. So this is the case to maximize the probability. Now suppose in the same problem, if they ask you to find that maximum probability, what you can do? The probability of choosing this bowl is half, and I will choose a ball. The probability of getting the red ball from this bowl is 1. Or I can choose this bowl. Probability of choosing this bowl is half, and I will choose one ball. The probability of getting a red ball from this bowl is 49/99. So this is the total probability. Okay. So this is the maximum probability of getting a red ball. Okay. So suppose if they ask about blue ball, you need to keep one blue ball in one bowl and keep all the remaining balls in another bowl. Okay. So the correct answer for this question is 99 balls are in the bowl with the larger number of balls. Just check this question. This question seems to be big, but it is very easy. This initial paragraph, they have given some information about what is length, what is dimensional analysis, mass is denoted by M, length is denoted by L, and time by T. And they have given some general information which is not that important. The important information starts from over here, this paragraph. Kinematic viscosity is denoted by K of a fluid is measure of its resistive force under gravity's influence. It is given by the equation K. So kinematic viscosity K is equal to N divided by D, where N is dynamic viscosity and D is density. Now, what is the basic question they have asked? They have asked what is the dimension of kinematic viscosity. Dimension, in other words, we can say what is the unit of kinematic viscosity. To find the unit of kinematic viscosity, we need to find the unit of dynamic viscosity and density. They have given us the unit of dynamic viscosity and density. First, we will check what is the unit of dynamic viscosity N. It is given by force into time divided by area. Okay, so remember this. Now we know that we measure force in newtons. So for unit of force is nothing but mass multiplied by length divided by time square. Okay, this is the unit of force. Again, we have over here multiplied by time upon area. Okay, now M, mass is denoted by M, length will be denoted by L, time will be denoted by T square, multiplied by time is denoted by T, and area. Area is nothing but length square. So just check, we can cancel out this. So here the unit of dynamic viscosity will be M upon T into L. Okay, now let's check what is the unit of density. Density is nothing but mass upon volume. Mass is denoted by M, volume is nothing but length cube. Okay, now what we need to do, we need to find the unit of kinematic viscosity, which will be equal to unit of dynamic viscosity divided by unit of density, that is M upon L cube. So if you solve this, okay, this will be equal to L square upon T. Okay, so L square upon T is nothing but it is L raised to 2 multiplied by T raised to minus 1. So if you check this, this correct option is option D, where it is written L square and T raised to minus 1. T raised to minus 1 means it is equal to L square upon T. So correct option for this question is option.
Let's check this question. A lady had some socks and hats in her closet, 17 blue, 47 red and 24 yellow. The lights are out and it is totally dark. In spite of the darkness, she can make out the difference between her hat and sock. She takes out an item out of the closet only if she is sure that it is a sock. How many socks must she take out to make sure she has two socks of each color? Now, there are various methods to solve this particular question, but rather than going in detail, I'll be telling you direct shortcut by using which you can get answer in less than 30 seconds. To find out answer of this question, the shortcut is you just need to add the maximum value plus medium value plus 2. Now, what is the maximum value we are having? 47 red, 24 yellow and 17 blue. So I will add maximum as 47. Middle value is 24 and then plus 2. So the answer for this question will be 47 plus 26, which will be 73. Don't go in detail about solving by method. Just use the shortcut and you will be able to find out answer. Maximum, what they will do, they will change the numbers. Add maximum plus medium value, or you can say middle value basically, plus 2, you will get your answer.
Okay, check this question. Bhaskar called his friend Shakuntala to celebrate his wedding anniversary. Shakuntala reached the street where he was living but forgot the door number. She called Bhaskar for his door number, but being a geek in maths, he didn't give the door number directly but told that it is the middle number of the three numbers, where the difference between first and second number is same as that between second and third. So basically there are three numbers, first, second and third. Okay, so middle number or the second number is actually his door number. So this second number we need to find. Okay, He also said that the difference between first and second is equal to the difference between second and third, and the product of first and last, or the first number multiplied by third number, is equal to 273, and addition of first, second and third number is equal to 51. Then we need to find the door number. Now first let's check what are the factors of 273 so that we can find what are the first and third numbers. So to find factors, I'll just divide by 3, this becomes 91. I'll divide by 7, this becomes 13, 1. So the factors of 273 are 3, 7 and 13. So what can be the probable first and third numbers? So first probability is that the first number is 3 and the third number is 91. So the multiplication, first number is 3 and third number is 91. So the multiplication is 273. Okay. Now, if you check what can be the second probability, probability is first number can be 13 and second number can be 21. Okay. What can be another probability? Another probability can be the first number can be 7 and the second number or the third number can be 39. Okay. So this is the probability that the first number and this is the third number, not second number, third number. Everywhere if you check, the product is equal to 273. Now, which can be the correct option from this? Now, this can be easily checked because they have given us one condition that the addition of three numbers is 51. So if addition of three numbers is 51, then this cannot be correct because directly here you have got the third number as 91. So addition is directly going above 51. So this cannot be the correct option. Now check the second one. If first number is 13 and third number is 21, then the second number should be in the middle. How will you find the middle number? 13 plus 21, that is 34, divided by 2. So you got the middle number 17. Here the difference is 4. Here also the difference is 4. Now let's check this case. If I take first number 7 and third number 39, then the middle number will be how much? 39 plus 7, that is 46, divided by 2, that is 23. But if 23 is the middle number or second number, the addition is greater than 51. So this option will also be eliminated. So the correct one is 13, 17 and 21. If you check the addition of this, it is equal to 51. So the door number is the middle number or it is 17. So 17 is the correct answer. First question of this third video. 12 liters of water is poured into an aquarium of dimensions 50 centimeter length, 30 centimeter breadth and 40 centimeter height. So basically this aquarium is in the shape of a cuboid. Okay. And they have given the length of that cuboid or aquarium as 50, breadth as 30 and height as 40. Okay. How high in centimeter will the water rise? So if we pour 12 liters of water in this cuboidal aquarium tank, then how much the height will rise? They are saying, okay. So in this question, we don't require the initial height of water. Okay. We need to just check how much the height will increase by. So what we can do for that, they have also given one information that 1 liter is 1000 centimeter cube. So 1 liter of water, the volume of 1 liter of water is 1000 centimeter cube. So definitely 12 liters of water, the volume will be 12,000 centimeter cube, right? So this is the volume of water which we are going to pour in the aquarium. So if this water is poured in the aquarium, then how high in centimeter will the water rise? Let us consider the height of rise as h. Okay, I will consider the height of water rise as h. Okay, we know that the water is going to have, it is going to get filled in this tank, right? And the length of the tank is 50. The breadth of the tank is 30 and the height of water we are considering as h, and the total volume of water is 12,000. So we know that in a cuboid, volume is length into breadth into height. So here we have considered length as 50, breadth as 30 and height as h because we want to check how high the water will rise. Okay. and we know that the volume of water which we are going to fill is 12,000. So just if we calculate this, just check what we will get as the answer. Okay, so we are getting h as 8 cm. So the correct answer for this question is 8 cm. Check this question. Twin brothers Love and Kush wrote the TCS NQD test. While Love scored 45% and got 4 marks below the cutoff, Kush scored 60% and got 8 marks above the cutoff and got selected for the interview. What was the maximum marks of the test? So there are two types of marks. One is the maximum marks and second one is the cutoff marks. Okay. So they told that Love scored 45%. So if we consider maximum marks as M and cutoff marks as C, Love has scored 45% of maximum marks and his marks were 4 marks below cutoff. So if he scored 45% of maximum marks, these marks were 4 less than the cutoff marks. So if cutoff marks are C, then minus 4 we have done because his marks were 4 less. Kush scored 60% marks. So basically Kush got 60% of maximum marks and he got 8 marks above cutoff. So we can say his marks were C plus 8. Then they are asking us what were the maximum marks. So we just need to find the value of M. So we'll subtract these two equations. So 45M by 100 minus 60M by 100 will become minus 15M by 100. C minus C will get cancelled. Minus 4 minus 8 will become minus 12. So I can cancel this minus sign. M will be equal to 12 into 100 divided by 15. So let us solve this. This will become 80. So maximum marks of the test were 80. So the correct answer for this question is 80. Okay, check this question. It is very interesting. A horse and a monkey together cost rupees 1100. Cost of horse is 1000 more than the monkey. Then the price of monkey is. See, this is very easy question, but in case of a hurry, some students can give answer of the price of monkey as 100, which is wrong. Just check what they have said. Cost of horse is 1000 more than the monkey. So if we consider cost of monkey as x, then x plus 1000 will be the cost of horse. And they have told us the together cost of monkey plus horse is 1100. So x plus 1000 will be equal to 1100. So if we check 2x is 100, x will be equal to 50. So the cost of or the price of monkey is rupees 50, which is the correct answer for this question. Check this question. In the normal course, Ravi, Sanjay and Mukund can individually build a wall in 5, 8 and 10 days respectively. So normally Ravi takes 5 days. Sanjay takes 8 days and Mukund takes 10 days to build a wall. This is in normal case. Okay. Due to difficult terrain and slushy conditions at the site, the individual time required for each to complete the work has increased by 20%, 25% and 50%. So due to bad site conditions, time taken by Ravi has increased by 20%. For Sanjay, it has increased by 25%. And for Mukund, it has increased by 50%. So now let's first calculate what is the new time they are taking to build that wall. Okay. So 5 days initially Ravi was taking. So 20% it has increased. So I can just multiply 5 by 120 upon 100. So if you check this, this will turn out to be 6. So the new time taken by Ravi to build the wall is 6 days. Okay. Similarly, we can calculate the time taken by Sanjay. He is taking 25% more time. So let's check how much time he is taking. So he is going to take, if you solve this, you will get the answer as 10. Okay. Next, the time taken by Mukund is increased by 50%. So I can just multiply this by 10. So here I am going to get 15 days. Okay, so due to bad conditions on site, Ravi takes 6 days now, Sanjay takes 10 days, and Mukund takes 15 days. Now they are saying how long they will take to build the wall if they work together. So now if they are working together, Ravi, Sanjay and Mukund, 6 days, 10 days and 15 days, how long they will take. So we are going to solve this by LCM method. So LCM of 6, 10 and 15 is 30. Now I will find the rate of each of them. So Ravi takes 6 days for 30 units of work. So per day he is going to complete 5 units, that is 30 divided by 6. Sanjay per day he is going to do 30 divided by 10, that is 3 units. And Mukund per day he is going to do 30 divided by 15, that is 2 units. So if all three of them are working together, per day they will complete 5 plus 3 plus 2, that is 10 units per day is the rate. Okay. So if 10 units per day is completed by 3 of them, to complete the whole work 30 units, they will take 30 by 10, that is 3 days. The correct answer for this question is 3 days.
Let's check this question. Bhaskar wanted to send some documents to Shakuntala. He had her address without the 6-digit PIN code. He didn't want to risk sending documents without PIN code. So he called Shakuntala. She did not give the PIN code directly. She said, the first 4 digits are 1910 in hexadecimal and the last 4 digits are 3177 in octal. Bhaskar could courier the documents now. What is her PIN code? Now let's check how we can solve this question. The first 4 digits which she has given is in hexadecimal. So we need to understand, we need to convert hexadecimal to decimal value. The hexadecimal value which they have given is 1910. We always take with respect to 16. So how we can convert a hexadecimal? Just you need to understand, the unit digit is 0. We multiply it by 16 raised to 0. Then at this particular position, second position, we are having 1. We need to multiply this with 16 raised to 1. In the next position, we are having 9. We need to multiply this with 16 raised to 2. And then we are having 1, which we need to multiply by 16 raised to 3. So we keep on multiplying by 16 raised to 0, then raised to 1, raised to 2. Now, if you do the calculation for this particular number, you will understand this particular number is 6416. Okay, so the first conversion or the first 4 digits which we are having, 1910 in this case, is 6416. Now the next about octal, the last 4 digits which she has given is in octal and that we need to convert to decimal. So how we can convert octal to decimal? The method will be same, just now we need to do octal conversion. So the value which they have given is 3177. At unit digit, we are having 7. Since it is octal, I will multiply it with 8 raised to 0. Then again 7, so 8 raised to 1. Then 1, so into 8 raised to 2. And then 3, so into 8 raised to 3. Now just try to do this calculation. Once you do the calculation, you will get answer like addition of this is 1663. Now what she has given, as we know, it is 6 digit number. So I will write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Out of which first 4 digits were hexadecimal which we converted and which we got 6416. And the next 4 digits or the last 4 digits which she has given are in octal which we converted and we got 1663. Out of that we already know 16 was at the 3rd position and 4th position. Then the last 2 digits will become 63. Then PIN code in that case will be 641663. So this is how you can convert. They will be providing you scientific calculator over there. So rather than adding by yourself, you can directly use calculator and get the answer for this. Okay, so the answer will be 641663.
Thank you for watching this particular video. We will be uploading a lot of videos about quantitative, verbal, programming concepts and coding part. So make sure you subscribe to our channel and don't forget to click on the bell icon to receive the updates. Also, make sure you join in our Telegram group as well. So whenever there is any update, you'll get it quickly. I have added link of WhatsApp group as well. So you can be part of our WhatsApp community also. Thank you.